want to go first, and I'm going to pass the ball to Clarissa. LA is the best city in the world, right behind New York City. Everyone wants to come to LA. Even though it's a difficult city to live in, with the traffic, congestion, potholes, the city going broke, tourism is up, corporate travel is up. But why do I love living in LA is because we're interfacing with exciting clients. We're interfacing with sunshine every day.
It's perfect weather.
we just have it all here, you know? Right. If you want to go to the beaches, you go to the beaches.
Right.
You want the snow, you go to Big Bear. There's everything here. There's nightlife. There's things to do with family. There's Disneyland.
But there's no place like home.
Right. Well, I think Los Angeles, because we're the gateway to Asia for the rest of the nation, and so that's very exciting. Anytime you're in a real cosmopolitan atmosphere, you're introduced to more.
It's got every industry here. So you can tap into startups, tech, pharmaceutical, entertainment. It gives you a variety of opportunities, and everybody has different travel needs. So you do have those people that do have to do all those international jobs, or that have companies in New York and do a lot of transcon, going from LA to New York, back and forth. So in LA, you've just got a variety here. And we're not a city that's dependent on one airline carrier or one hotel chain. We have a variety. We have choice here. And that really works well for the corporations and the businesses that are in LA, because they can now leverage. So I think that's what makes LA strive to get bigger and better and to bring in more business where needed, because we're able to offer so many choices that are going to work for that client.
I think that's a great point. I think because we're diversified, it's exciting. Exciting.
It's also where you can grow to in your career. I've worked resorts, I've worked hotels, mm-hmm. I've worked transportation, I've worked rental car. I'm ready to sell the city. I'm ready to sell LA because I feel like I've gotten a roundabout education. I know what a hotel means. I know what the theme park means. I know what the super shuttle, I know what the driver needs. I know what the guest needs. So when you're here, you can transfer. You make all these connections with everybody in your industry. You're able to say, I want to go to the Westin. I want to go work there. I want to go to the Hilton. You can get your way in rather than, you know, staying at the Spring Hill Suites in Podunk City.
Okay, now we've just ruined it for Kansas City,
Indiana,
and what did it say? We're not gonna take it.
No, you got to look at Chicago's good, yeah. Atlanta's good, Texas, Dallas, Houston.
Yeah, I thought I'd go to Austin.
Austin is huge right now. Austin is really big.
It's vertical in the big city. It's upward movement. You could fail, you could succeed. But coming out of this recession for Flowers Hotel Group is my great success story. But I think also you have to have failure to create success. And I really believe that.
I grew up in Hawaii on the Big Island, Volcano Island in Hilo, very small town. And while my family could afford to island hop, so you're going from one rock to the next, the people, the language, the food, everything was the same. And so you had to get on an airplane if you wanted to go anywhere. And I think very early on I made it kind of my dream job was to work for an airline. And fortunately, after I graduated from school in Oregon, you know, it all kind of fell into place.
Speaking more on the airline side, my background, at least, that got me inspired to work in travel was to be a flight attendant. And I think all of us could look back to those years of Pan Am and Western when it was the most glamorous thing in the world to do is to be a flight attendant. And I idolized that so much and chose that I wanted that path because it would give me the opportunity to see the world and experience different cultures and different people and understand how they travel and why they travel, because everybody walks on a plane with a different purpose of why they're there. So I was fortunate enough to become a flight attendant and be a flight attendant for many years and really understand the service of travel and the experiences that people had going from point to point, whether it be for business or for leisure or honeymoon or even a sad situation where they're getting on a plane. And to be able to have that face-to-face time just excited me even more in this industry of just how far we can take it. Yes, it's very glamorous and it's very hard work, but it's rewarding.
being in the travel industry, it's the greatest field to be in. And it just has a lot to offer. And I got to travel all over for Westin, Four Seasons. But with my own company, I've worked Turkey, Russia. It's been amazing.
A lot of my friends that I went to school with can't keep up with my travel schedule. They always leave me messages, where are you now? And that was before Facebook. You know, where are you now? Where are you going now?
My start was that with the Century Plaza, working as a hostess, I realized I could sell this. It was a fabulous hotel. And it was a little hard getting started because they didn't want to hire women in sales. So I left, came back again as a hostess, still wouldn't hire me, left again, came back. And I was the first woman for the Century Plaza Hotel. And I went from there and got my experience. I booked presidents, I booked Fergie and Andrew at the Four Seasons, and there were many when I was working at the Four Seasons. Many, many stars. I mean, when we first opened the first Academy Award, we had 32 of the nominees in the hotel. And Jessica Tandy was one of them, and she won. And I booked her. So they just went on and on. I mean, my career was just fabulous on property.
For Adriana and myself, we are the only two women in our office that have a manager position. Everyone else is a man. I mean, we deal consistently. If you look at transportation, limo, shuttle, taxi, you're going to find men in sales roles. You're going to find men. And so we kind of have to be you know, we're these tough girls walking. Yeah. We got to sit down.
Right.
Yeah.
So how do we weave in the men component to make sure that we're not disrespecting the young men in the audience?
Because you don't want to start in. It's got women running this, women running all of it. We sound like,
women
let's get up and burn our bras. I mean, where are you going here?
But I do want to see women running airlines. I got to see new panels every year.
We're not that industry hasn't evolved yet. If you go to technology companies, some of the top women are running.
Who's always down.
They just had the girl on.
But they're running it.
I just take Katie the other day, and the girl, the president of Facebook,
Facebook.
She's a woman. Mm-hmm. So there are women running industries, but let's don't campaign on that. Like, we've got to get all these kids interested, boys and girls.
I know, right? Okay, good. Thank you.
From the airline perspective, you know, traditionally, I think the executive management team, as with Super Shuttle, mm-hmm. tends to be men, or it has traditionally for the two airlines I worked for anyway. But you do see women entering at maybe mid-management levels, or even from the front line, you know, bottom up, working their way up. Talent is talent, so it's going to be recognized wherever you are, whatever company you're at. So I think there's a spot for everybody in the travel industry, but it has to be your passion. Whether you're female or male, if you love the industry, love your job, or have a passion for flying or any of it, that's what's going to shine through and you'll be successful.
In the hotel business, when I started, I was the only woman and there were 8 men. And now today, there are as many women, and you know, they're running hotels, they're directors of sales, they're managers of hotels, and one of my hotels that I have, she's the one in Paris, she owns the hotel. Like you say, talent, they can't keep us back.
Beautiful.
For men and women to start, they start as bellmen, or they start as concierge or front desk, and they work their way up. It's hard work, that really. Like, it's a talent. Mm-hmm. You have the talent, the drive, and the hard work. And if you put that hard work, you can go anywhere. I mean,
I really believe, yes, experience, the harder you work, everything I did was hard work. I mean, the hours I gave, the weekends I gave up, and everything, but it got me to where I'm going.
And those first sales calls too, when you come into the industry and you go in,
it's hard.
They like shut the door in your face and you just want to go and cry.
No, it's not easy. It's not easy.
It's competitive. I mean, I worked, my first sales position was in rental car. I worked for a Highline rental car company. It's called Beverly Hills Rent a Car. And we had a competitor, Midway. And I will never forget, like, we had different products.
But for some reason, when the year I came in, people just did not like the company. And it was very hard to swallow when we used it right. And I was like, okay, but I'd still go see them, and I'd still build the relationship. And slowly but surely, when they needed me, they could call on me. And I was there.
But they use Midway, and they use your competitors, or they use you because of the relationship that the salesperson cultivated. It's the relationship.
And you just keep going in there. And then one day, they're going to need you. And that's when you reel them in.
Exactly.
What's fun now about doing sales, and it's corporate sales, is going up to clients that need your help. People buy from people they like. People buy from people they trust. And if you're able to provide them with a solution in travel that makes that experience just a little bit better, then it's such a rewarding feeling.
Being from the airlines, I think one of our biggest challenges in the past 2 years has been competing with video conferencing in terms of sales meetings. And I have to say that over time, most corporations have found that the first piece of travel that has returned within their company is the face-to-face contact. Everything is automated from online to mobile applications that help you travel quicker and faster. But the moment your traveler gets to the airport, what are they looking for? They want to have individualized attention to meet their personal needs that in that moment. And it's a stressful thing. Travel is stressful. But, you know, it's real life experiences. And I think unless you have people behind the counter that can help them in that situation, it's difficult.
There's always room for technology. It's there for instant gratification, but it's not going to make it solid for the rest of the time. You have to bridge that and show a happy medium between technology and that personal touch.
I think the most important aspect about that personal connection and that personal relationship is understanding the culture of that company and the client that you're working with. You can never understand the culture or the personality of the company until you pick up the telephone or unless you're in front of that customer.
Because everybody's different and you just don't know who you're going to be dealing with in this industry. So getting the best training, the best guest service, and the best education you can get will really inspire you to work hard in this industry.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I agree. Yes. I agree with this education.
Absolutely.
Well, for me, it's been quite a fun ride. It's always been, for me, the transportation industry. You know, sitting behind a desk, now being in sales, it's as you're making that building that relationship with all these other suppliers, corporations, you know, you build a friendship as well.
It's a great way to make a living. Yeah. It's a great way to make a living, to provide for your family, provide for your future. It's through the travel and tourism field. Absolutely.
I asked Merv Griffin one time, I said, you've had talk shows, you've owned companies. I said, why the hotel business? Tell me, why did you pick the hotel business? And he said, Linda, it's just like show business. You got to bring them in, entertain them, and bring them back. And I said, I never realized I was in show business.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
It is an entertaining business.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we wouldn't change it for the world.
I love that.
That's right.
Uh-huh, this my shit.